and generals, it's Friday, and I'm Max Owens. This is Brady Chandler. We have yet another edition of Five Star News cooked up for you today. So, what do you say about that, Brady?
I say, let's eat. The appetizer today is going to be an old reliable we call What's Up Heritage. Here's Isaac Delk and Kieron Freed with that report.
Welcome back to What's Up Heritage. Now, let's get on to some Friday announcements. First, Heritage was named AP Honors in two categories, and I can confidently say that Heritage is going high. Next up, our play Little Women will premiere on March 8th through 11th. Prices may vary on the dates it's premiering. And lastly, if you're planning on doing dual enrollment, now is the time to apply for it. Be sure to talk to your counselors about how you can apply. Now, let's get to the weather with our weatherman, Isaac Delk.
Thanks, Kieran. Now, let's get on to the weather. For Friday, it'll be showers with a high 60 and a low 53. On Saturday, it'll be nothing but showers with a high 61 and a low 56. And for Sunday, it'll be cloudy with a high 72 and a low 61. So bring an umbrella this weekend. Now, let's get back to the anchors for more news.
Thanks, Gus, for that report. Moving on now to the news, where senior writer Caden Moore found out yesterday that the poem she wrote is receiving some pretty big honors.
Sure is, Max. Moore's poem called Pretty People won first place in the competition, and she received a gold ball, and the poem will be put on display at the SCAD as well.
Pretty big accolades. How does Caden feel about the recognition? We talked to her yesterday to get her reaction.
So we were recently informed that Heritage senior Caden Moore has been awarded the Gold Key Award from the Scholastic Arts and Writing Council. This is for her poem, Pretty People, and it's a big honor to receive this award. It's sort of the top tier award out of this category of awards.
The name is Pretty People, and it's kind of about how women kind of have to deal with the term pretty when, like, facing different kind of, like, obstacles in life, and how pretty is the important thing. I'm super excited that I won, and it being displayed at SCAD is such, like, a prestigious thing, and I'm really excited for people to be able to see my work.
Since she's a Gold Key Award winner, her poem will be sent to the national level for consideration for a national medal. The Scholastic Arts and Writing organization is pretty prestigious. Past judges over like the past 50, 60 years have included pretty famous poets like Langston Hughes, Robert Frost, Nikki Giovanni. So her poem will be read by some pretty prestigious people and people who know what they're talking about. Personally, I'm very proud of Caden. She was a member of my dramatic writing class last semester, and this poem wasn't written for that class specifically, but she has written several things for me, and we've developed a good working relationship. So it's really nice to see her honored in this way.
Congrats, Caden. That's really cool.
Another really cool thing that happens here at HHS every Wednesday is...
Oh, I know. We get out an hour early on Wednesdays.
Well, yes, we do, Bertie, but I'm not talking about that. What I was talking about is we have PBIS awards that we hand out every Wednesday.
Oh, okay. I got you now. Those are pretty nice.
Well, for those that don't know about those awards, you can earn one.
How does it work? Well, let's get you over to Five Star News reporter Crew Norman for more details.
Well, it's a initiative we have here at school to recognize students that are going above and beyond the normal. So it could be that they've done something in class. They could have helped a teacher out. They could have they could have escorted a new student around, showing them through the day and the schedule and that sort of thing. Just anything to kind of just where you're honoring your school and helping other people out and so forth. It's just our way of doing something very small by giving them a reward on Wednesdays. The slip they get to redeem on Wednesdays for an ice cream. So it's just a way of us to thank our students for doing what they do. They do an awful lot of good things here in the building, and it's just our way of trying to recognize that.
I was in Ms. Kemp's room. Helped my friend, been a little late to class. Helped him pick up his stuff. And just helped him out, you know. Teacher caught eye of it. She decided to give me a PBIS.
You know, me, William Crew Norman, I have received a PBIS reward from Ms. Shulin, okay? and I helped her clean up her classroom. And the next Wednesday, I went and got a freaking ice cream, dog. Yeah, ice cream sandwich, vanilla ice cream sandwich. It hit.
Our day off every day with Mr. Bradford will reference it at the end of all the morning announcements that he does. As you go throughout the building, you're going to see all kinds of posters and things that are on the walls to remind students of what the expectations are, whether they're in the theater or whether they're in the hallways or in the media center. So it's a constant reminder throughout the building and so forth.
I have to say, the ice cream is really nice.
And cold. Time for a break now, Max, but stick around for sports.
Yeah, and y'all don't want to miss all the stuff we have in store for you today. We have the girls' basketball, tennis, soccer, and way more.
Well, Generals, if you miss a lot of things, you certainly do not want to miss this. Our general merchandise is having a huge sale, including shirts and sweaters. Well, I'd get some other gear, like our coasters and car stickers. So what are you waiting for? Get your Team Spirit gear today.
Welcome into sports, everyone. It's your favorite tag team duo, Jonathan and Lauren here, and we've got a lot to cover, and we're going to start with girls basketball.
We sure will, and it's a big day for our team because we play the number one team in the state of Georgia in the Sweet 16.
Yes, and that team is Holy Innocence. What are the girls' chances of pulling it off? We talked to Coach Elkins and a few girls on the game.
Yeah, big travel day tomorrow, driving down to Holy Innocence in Atlanta for our second round state playoff game. Just completely honest, I think we're all really excited about the opportunity. I think the team we're going to play is a very good basketball team, but so was the team that we played Tuesday night. So I think for us, being the underdog for the majority of the year and most of the games we've played is nothing new to us. So I don't think that'll impact us one bit. I think we'll have a couple of really good days of preparation. Get prepared to play a really athletic basketball team. They're pretty dynamic. They have two really good guards on the perimeter who can guard without much help, and also on the offensive end, they're very quick and can knock down open shots, so they can score on all three levels, at the basket, mid-range, and three, so it's difficult to guard, but the way we defend and our defensive principles, I think we'll be fine as long as we stick to those principles.
So our Sweet 16 game is against Holy Innocence. They're a pretty good basketball team, so pretty excited to see how we match up against them. I'm not gonna lie, they're pretty skilled. So I'm hoping that our defense will be as good as it can be against them, hopefully shut down some of their key players and hold them to a low score in like the 70s every game, so hopefully we can hold them under that. Hopefully our offense will travel with us too, because it's win or go home, so hopefully we can put up a good fight and hopefully make something happen.
Good luck to you, Lauren, and good luck to the rest of the team and coaches tonight.
Thanks, Jonathan. To soccer now, and both of the teams are in action this week, and both games ended in ties.
Sure did. The boys battled to a 2-2 tie against Tryon, while the girls were a little short-staffed and tied River Ridge.
Five-star sports reporters Gabe, Silas, and Tipton talked to the team and coaches about their outcomes.
And then the varsity took the field at 7 against a good Tryon team, an undefeated Tryon team. We scored early, Tipton to Tristan with a header from about midfield. It was really nice.
Yesterday we played Tryon. It ended up in a draw. It was a pretty good game, two pretty even teams. We actually ended up coming back in the second half. We were down 2-1. It's the first time we've ever scored on an opponent after they've scored. So it's kind of nice that we came back. We fought hard, but, they were just a really good team, pretty even match. So I wasn't too upset with the draw, but I would have liked to go with the win.
Tryon was up 2-1 at half. And we talked about resilience. We've been working on character and fighting hard. We're not a bad soccer team, but hopefully I was wanting to see some more fight from the guys. Not to win, but against a good trying team, we'll take the tie and we'll keep moving forward. I felt like I saw some resilience from the kids I haven't seen yet.
So on Tuesday, the girls soccer team went down to River Ridge. It's a 6A school down around Woodstock, and they were a really, really talented squad. They were super fast. And our girls gave them all they wanted. And we had kind of a shorthanded roster. We got a bunch of injuries, a couple of girls gone to Nicaragua. But I was really proud of the effort. We had really one sub for the whole game, and so the girls were playing the whole game pretty much and giving all they got.
We tied 1-1, but our goalkeeper played really well. Without her, we definitely would have lost. Offensively, we played all right, but defensively, we played really well.
Ended up with a 1-1 tie, which is a really good result down there, considering our lineup and considering that they're really good. So it was a good match for us. We got tested. We had to defend. Our keeper had to work. Some of the things we haven't really had to do much early on in the season. So it's a good test for us and a good result.
Congrats, guys and girls. Well, I guess congrats. You didn't win, but you didn't lose either. But the guys did get a 4-3 win over Model last night, so I guess the real congrats goes to them.
Now to tennis, and both our boys and girls squads hit the court at home yesterday in a non-region match against Gordon Lee.
The boys were looking to go 2-0 on the season, while Coach Mathis's girls were seeking their first win of the season.
Could they get it done against the Trojans? My guess is yes. Here's Coach Green with his match recaps.
Boys tennis team got another win today against Gordon Lee. The singles did it again today. We picked up three wins, all three singles. So nice job from Caleb Biddle. 6-0 against a guy that was a pretty good player. I was impressed with the way Caleb played today. He had a lot of nice shots, forehands, backhands. His serve was pretty good.
I thought I played decent. I could have played better, but he was a good opponent. I just was able to stay pretty calm for most of the match and stay very composed for the most part.
And he just really put it to the player who was a pretty good player. Dario Fonio at number two is really solid. He don't really have a weak part of his game. He's got good ground strokes, and today he hit a lot of passing shots against the guy from Gordon Lee. 6-2, 6-1 for him, so a relatively easy win for Dario.
I feel good. I played a pretty good match, and 6-2, 6-1. I enjoyed it.
And then finally, Thomas Culpepper did it again. He had probably the closest match so far before the doubles are finished. Tight in the first set, he pulls it out 6-4. Second set, he gets behind 4-3, keeps battling, ends up winning 6-4, 6-4.
I feel like I did all right. I could have done better, some things I could work on. Serving, I started out pretty well. It kind of died off. Serving's something I need to work on. But, I mean, overall, I mean, I got it done. Could have done it probably quicker, better, but, I mean, got it done.
2-0 heading into the match against Dalton next week. So we're pretty proud of the guys and hope we can keep the streak going. Our doubles are still out there right now, but the match is already clinched. So hopefully they'll pull off some wins for us there, and we'll get ready for Dalton on Tuesday.
So yesterday our girls played Gordon Lee, and we won. Our 2-1 singles won their matches. That was me on number one, and so we sealed it for playing Gordon Lee. Our doubles teams continued to play Gordon Lee, and we saw some really nice results.
Hey, so yesterday the girls tennis team played Gordon Lee. Compared to Christian Heritage that we played on Monday, Gordon Lee was more on our same pace, and we played the same as they do, so it was a really good matchup. We ended up winning 3-2. All of our singles players, Mia Callahan, Ella Blancett, and Rachel Brown won. And then our doubles, who again are mostly very new, they're still learning how to play and getting their footing down. But what I'm hopeful for is seeing our doubles develop and continuing to get wins in our singles.
Overall, the match was very nice, and the weather was getting warmer. It was a little humid, but that's expected around this time of year. We're just glad it's not freezing cold and it wasn't raining yesterday. I think that the girls overall did really well. We had a lot of cheering on the team, and we're doing really good at supporting each other with that.
To entertainment now, and we have a few great segments for you today. And we'll start with our favorite set of HHS twins, the Gonzalez boys. And today, their Twin and M segment, they're talking indie music.
Not even going to ask. Really, guys.
What's up, Heritage? It's Ian M.
And it's Ethan M.
And today, we're going to be talking about indie music. Let's run it up.
I like indie or alternative because it's a little slower. It's not fast-paced like rap or heavy metal. And it's just something you can chill and listen to in your room. But I like Vacations, Good Morning, probably Mac DeMarco, Comfort Chain, bands like that.
What's your name?
Mason.
And what do you think about indie music?
I like it. I listen to a lot of it. A lot of smaller bands, you know, they got a certain kind of sound. Just kind of experimental. I like it a good bit.
What differentiates indie music from other type of genres?
Indie, a little bit more experimental. You can get a little wild with it. You know, you can have like classic rock band, but still have, you know, like crazy synths, all kind of stuff. And it's not really based around drums necessarily, whereas like trap is like mostly drums. You know, it's a lot of experimenting. You can kind of make your own sound with it. It's not just like R&B and trap where it's like one sound. It's kind of anything.
Who's your favorite indie artist?
I like a good amount of Tame Impala. You know, he got some psychedelic music, and I kind of like that. But if I were to say somebody a little bit smaller, probably The Districts. They're a smaller band. They got some bangers.
Thanks, you two. And now to the sixth episode of Tune Talk. And you know the drill by now, Brady.
Yeah, if you wear a band shirt to school, make sure you know some of that band's history. Take it away, guys.
What's up, Tune Talk? I'm Nolan Kaler, and I'm here with
Ethan Gonzalez.
He's got on a
Ken Carson shirt.
All right, Ethan, can you tell me a little bit about the Ken Carson?
Yeah, he makes trap music. It's pretty fire.
What's three facts about him?
He's from Atlanta. He looks like a Goomba, and he's part of the Opium label. That Playboy card he made.
Ooh. What's your top three favorite songs by Ken Carson?
Get Rich or Die, So What, and Rock and Roll.
You know how many number one hits Ken Carson has?
Probably zero.
We'll fact check that. But until do, we'll see you next time.
They should have known that the Gonzalez twins know his music. And now, time for a brand new entertainment segment.
Yes, the Sarcastic Little World crew has put that skit on the back burner for now, and they've took their talents to a new spot called The Classmates.
What is this all about? Here's Nathan Collard, Day Ramsey, Bellistonio, and Allie Powers.
Hey, did you move the clips? Oops. What are you doing? I literally told you to take care of it.
I think I forgot to care.
And I am so sick of Vi. Every day, she gives me this rude response or just doesn't help out. I'm going to blow up in her face one day.
Hi there, I'm Vi. Welcome to this cluster of a chaos we call the classroom. Me personally, I like to think that I make this place run.
Guys, I think we just need to talk things out, you know, take a breather.
Can everyone just shut up?
Hi, I'm Phoebe, and I'm just very happy to be here with my friends.
Hey, all of these people, Vi and Mark are always fighting, and Phoebe is always looking on the bright side. It gets so annoying.
And with that, let's get to the weekend.
I like the sound of that, but don't worry. We'll be back Tuesday with a brand new report. But until then,
stay classy, Heritage.